Hello, my little naughties. Welcome to Goya Tales. It is Diwali and all of us are so excited to celebrate this festival, right? With our family, with friends, with lots of new clothes and sweets. It's going to be so much fun. And I'm sure all of you would have heard the story, the reason behind us celebrating this festival, right? So there are actually a lot of books also for children, which is about Diwali. And they all talk about how Lord Rama, he defeated Ravana and when he came back home, which is Ayodhya. So this day is celebrated as Diwali, correct? But do you all know, not just this story, there are other stories also. There are other reasons why we celebrate this festival. In fact, in South India, especially in Tamil Nadu, we call this festival as Deepavali. Okay, we don't call it Diwali, we call it Deepavali. And we have a totally different story, which is the reason why we celebrate this festival. And as I said, similarly, other parts of the country, you know, there are different parts of the country which have different stories as well. But I'm going to tell you the story of why we celebrate Deepavali in Tamil Nadu. And I'm going to tell the story from a book, which is called The Festival of Light and Deepavali Legends from all across the country, all across India. Because I told you, right, there are many stories about Deepavali. And this book actually explains all the stories. This book has seven stories about Deepavali from different parts of the country. So these stories are told by Radhika Shekhar and this book is illustrated by Catherine E. Allen and it's edited by Sylvia Pollard and designed by David Bador and this book is published by Vakils Pfeffer and Simons Private Limited. So what is this story? What is the story about? In Tamil Nadu, we celebrate Deepavali because this is the day when a very very bad asura called Naraka. So Naraka asura was defeated and that is the story I'm going to share with you today. Okay, so long ago there was this asura. Asura is a demon, right? So his name was Naraka and like other asuras he was also so huge and strong and powerful. On top of it he had also received a boon from Lord Brahma. Who is Lord Brahma? He has four faces and he is called the creator, right? So he has created all of us. So Lord Brahma had given a boon to Naraka, which said that, you know, he will be so powerful and he will not be defeated by males, which is men of all the three kinds. Asuras, Devas, Devas mean the gods, right? So Devas or even Manusha, which is normal man who live on earth. So none of the males, none of the men will be able to fight and defeat Naraka. So for this reason, Narakasura was growing rude and arrogant every day. And you know, it was really getting too much because he started abusing and bullying everybody. He started looting everybody. He started stealing everybody's things. Kingdoms and you know all their wealth, everything. And he conquered all the three worlds. What are the three worlds? The underworld where all the asuras and demons live and you know the normal world, the earth on which all of us live and Devaloka. So Devaloka is heaven where all the gods live. So he even conquered Devaloka and he expelled, means sent out whom? Lord Indra, who is the king of Devas. So Narakasura conquered all the three worlds and Lord Indra, no, because he was defeated by an asura, he became so bad, you know, so sad and upset. So he came running to Lord Vishnu asking for help. And at that time, Lord Vishnu was living on earth as Lord Krishna. So he was in his Krishna avatar. And he was at Dwaraka. So that is where Krishna's kingdom is, right? So in Dwaraka, Krishna was with his queen Satyabhama. And at that time, Lord Indra, he came running. See, Lord Indra came running and he told Lord Krishna and Satyabhama. So he like just opened the doors in a rush. And Krishna looked at Indra and was like, "What happened, Indra? What is this? Why have you come like this? You look so worried. Tell me what happened." And Indra said, "Oh Lord Krishna, just look at this Narakasura. He is becoming unstoppable. Nobody is able to control him. He is looting and taking away all our things. And he is, you know, hitting and harassing all of us. It is getting very, very difficult. You are the only one who will be able to save us. Help us, please, Lord Krishna." And then Krishna said, okay, yes, I think it is, you know, really going beyond control. We have to put an end to this." But then Krishna said, he has this boon, right? So Narakasura has this boon. So it is going to be difficult. Let me try. So Krishna started. So he wanted to go and fight Naraka. He took all his weapons. He prepared his chariot. And he called his queen Satyabhama to come and ride the chariot for him. Because Satyabhama was also very, very good at, you know, fighting. So she has learned warfare, right? So she will be able to, she knows how to ride a chariot. She knows how to fight. She knows how to do bow and arrow. So she is also very good at it. And she was really happy and proud that, okay, Krishna is going on a, such an important job and he wants me to accompany him. So she felt proud. And they started. Their chariot, so Queen Satyabhama and Krishna, so they set off in a chariot which had these five white fine horses. So these five white horses, so they were pulling the chariot in which Krishna and Satyabhama were going. And it was a very, very dark night. It was a new moon day. New moon means there won't be any moon, right? It is like just before new moon. So very thin sliver of moon, only that was seen. It was almost not there. It was almost not visible at all. So the night was really dark and the path was also so rough. So, but Queen Satyabhama, since she is good at riding a chariot, she was, you know, successfully managing the chariot on the path. Suddenly, out of nowhere, there was a huge boulder. Boulder means a huge rock. It came and fell on their way. So they were all shocked. The horses were shocked. But then Krishna said, this is Naraka's trickery. Let me just break it. So he took his mace. Mace means the gada, the gadai, right? So they say. So with that help of the mace, he broke. He hit the rock so hard, it broke into 1,000 pieces. And now the path was clear again. So they started going. So they continued on their path. And when they were going, suddenly, again, what happened? There were a lot of weapons, all these sharp weapons like spears, arrows, and swords, all these sharp weapons. So they started flying and coming. They fell on the ground right before their chariot. So again, the horses, Queen Satyabhama, they all were shocked. And Krishna was growing, you know, really impatient. He was like, all this is Naraka's work. Let me just clear this in a moment. So he took out his bow and arrow, and Krishna also, he started he started firing arrows at all the weapons, and they all broke into pieces, right? So once again their path was clear and they continued. Well, they almost approached, they were right before Naraka's fortress, the kingdom, right, the palace. When they were almost there, immediately the door opened, it burst open, and so many, a big group of asuras, they came running from inside. They came towards Krishna's chariot, and all of them looked really huge and cruel and all of this. So when they were coming, again the horses, they got scared, right? The horses, they started neighing, and you know, they became restless and they moved here and there. And Krishna was like, don't worry. This is all his work. Let me take care of these asuras. All these army of asuras, what are they before my strength? So Krishna boldly, he jumped onto the ground and he fought with all the asuras and he defeated them in such a short time. So, after all this, they finally reached his Naraka's kingdom, and in front of their door, Krishna was really angry now. So he shouted, he roared, "Naraka, enough of all your trickery and great games and all of these things. If you're really brave, I am here standing right at your door. Come and face me." So Krishna was so angry and he called out for Naraka. And Narakasura, he was also angry. So he came riding his elephant. So he came out from his kingdom, the fort. And he was like, he looked at Krishna and he shouted. He's like, "Hey, you fool." He called Krishna a fool. He was like, "Don't you know that I am so powerful? And none of you people, like no male can defeat me. Don't you know this?" By saying this, he took a long spear, a sharp spear, and he threw at Lord Krishna. And he started laughing. He was like, "Ha ha ha ha." He threw it, and that spear, it hit Krishna's shoulder. So when it hit Krishna's shoulder, Queen Satyabhama was really shocked to see this. And after this, Lord Krishna, he fell down on his chariot. And looking at it, Narakasura started laughing even more. He was like, "Ha ha ha ha, this was so easy. I didn't even expect that it will be, so easy to defeat Lord Krishna." When he was doing that, Satyabhama became so angry and furious, and she said, "Hey Naraka, you have a boon. Yes, you might be powerful than all the men, but do you dare to fight with me? I am a woman. Come and fight with me." Narakasura did not expect this, because he was like surprised. "Hey, what? A woman? A queen? She is challenging me. What can she do?" So he looked at Satyabhama and he said, "You? What do you think you can do to me? Even Krishna is defeated. He is down now. So what do you think you can do? I will just crush you like a bug," Naraka said. And while he was talking, and he was not even prepared before that, Satyabhama acted so quickly, and she took the bow and arrows and she started firing them at Narakasura, and they all hit him and he fell down because he was not even ready. He did not have his weapon or anything. So when Satyabhama was so quick and clever and she attacked him, he fell down when all the arrows hit him. And asuras, it is said that they lose all their power when they fall to the ground. So as soon as Narakasura fell to the ground, what happened? He lost all his power. And Satyabhama, with her bow and arrows, she was so brave and she hit him even more, and Naraka was defeated. Because he lost his power, he fell to the ground and he was defeated. Now everybody became so happy. Indra was also very happy because he felt so upset to be defeated by an asura, right? So he was also happy. And all the other people, everybody, they started rejoicing. "Yay, Naraka is no more. Now we can all be so happy." And Krishna, who is none other than Lord Vishnu, so he was just pretending to be wounded, right? Because he is so strong. He is the Lord. He is the Lord Vishnu. And he woke up. So he stood up and he also praised Satyabhama, "That wonderful queen, you were so clever and you were so brave, and you have now defeated Naraka." So everybody, they started, cheering for Lord Krishna and for Queen Satyabhama. And they lit fireworks because to celebrate Naraka's defeat. And since it was a dark night, they lit so many lamps for the king and the queen to get back to their kingdom. So this is the reason why even till date, we light a lot of, diyas, candles, and, we burst firecrackers, we celebrate with sweets and new clothes and all of that. So this is the story of Deepavali, which we celebrate in Tamil Nadu, and I think in many other South Indian states too. Along with this story, this book also, you know, I told you this book has 7 stories, right? So, along with Naraka's defeat, it also explains, this has the Ramayana story too, where Lord Rama defeats Ravana and comes back to Ayodhya. And the other stories of, you know, churning of the ocean, the goddess who would not stop dancing, 3 steps of land, the humbling of Indra, and a brother's gift. So these are the other stories in this book. So if you want to know more about Deepavali stories and, you know, to understand, okay, so this is the reason why these people celebrate all the, you know, even in North India, right? So you have like 5 different days of Diwali and there is a story for doing, for celebrating each of those 5 days. To know about all this, try to get this book and read all the stories. Have a wonderful and a very fun-filled and a happy Deepavali to all of you. All right? Bye-bye.